Afternoon. First of all, I would like to thank the organizer of this EAA session for giving me the opportunity to participate in the discussion about sanctuaries in Eubea and its colonies. Another special thanks must go to the Foundation Theodore Lagonico that found my project. The main aim of my project is to provide insights into the cultural interactions and social transformation between Greeks and Italic population during the early Iron Age. Today, I will present the preliminary results of my study focused on the comparison between the production and cultic use of Enotrian Eubean pottery from the sanctuary of Francavilla Marittima and the Eubean geometric pottery from the sanctuary of Apollo in Eretria. I have conducted two study campaigns in the Archaeological Museum of Eretria and in the Archaeological Museum of the Sibaritide in order to select the appropriate vessel for the implementation of the project. Subsequently, I have analyzed by digital microscopy, microtraces and X-ray analysis the two pottery productions. I have registered parallels and differences in the ceramic assemblage. The cultural influence that Greek newcomers and on the local community of southern Italy during the early Iron Age has recently been subject of intense discussion. Scholars interpreted these encounters either as a conflictual interactions or a more complex and dynamic process. Both theories are based on formal, stylistical, and contextual features of the material culture and on the cultural behavior and transformation of the Italic population. Research in the centuries of Eretria offers a field of reflection about shared ritual practice and the relationship between Greeks and native people in a wider perspective. Like in the most of cult plays, ceramic artifacts are the most important source of information to understand the ritual acts performed while offering access to social practice within communities. For instance, locally produced vessel recently found in the site of Francavilla Marittima in the Sibaritide exhibit a hybrid character between Eubean wheel-thrown pottery and local Enotrian Eubean shapes. The production of this so-called Enotrian Eubean pottery could suggest peaceful contacts with Greeks prior to the foundation of the Greek colony of Sybaris. Most of the Enotrian Eubean pottery was found during the excavation in the sanctuary on the Timpone della Motta. The archaeological site of Timpone della Motta is located on a hill between the today's village of Francavilla Marittima and the Raganello River, nearby the Greek polis of Sibari on the Ionian Sea. An important sanctuary was located on its top. The first structure of this hill is a Middle Bronze Age house, on top of which, much later, an apsidal longhouse was constructed, which was in use during the third quarter of the 8th century BC. It was replaced by a rectangular wooden building with Greek plan around the last quarter of the 8th century BC. However, in the second half of the 7th century BC, the sanctuary was apparently a place where Sibaritis people celebrated large festivals. The repertoire of the Enotrian Eubean production consists mostly on Greek type skiphoi and indigenous type skodelle bowl, but during the second half of the 8th century BC, the production expanded to include larger craters, lecanae, calatisco, inokoi, amphorae, and biconical jars, decorated with typical Eubean motifs. In the sanctuary, the largest proportion has been identified in contexts related to the sacred building 5b and 5c, which were in use during the 8th century BC. And at the same moment, there were produced also other kind of vessels, like the grey ware, the impasto pottery, and the matte painted pottery. Why is important to study how pottery was produced in the ancient society? The study of pottery production is correlated to the determination of how pottery was made, who made it, and for whom it was made. These questions are related to the manufacturing technology, to the role and status of producers, to the integration between task, organization of production, and relationship between producer as consumers. With the aim to reconstruct the production of the selected vessels and to distinguish the different genre repertoire of local and foreign pottery practice, I perform macroscopic, microscopic, and X-ray analysis. Macroscopic and microscopic analysis allow the technique that the superficial traces of manufacturing and finishing techniques. These marks can contribute to a reconstruction of the technological process involved in shaping of a vessel and its surface treatment. In the first image, you see the throwing grooves inside a crater fragment. In the second one, this is the external surface of a crater showing traces of the preparation sketch. The other images is related to a grooves on bottom foot were created when the potter cut vessel off wheel with a cord. Then we have the irregular striations left by a brush to paint the internal surface of a skiffos, the striation made by fingers running over wet clay in the inner surface of a skiffos, and the last image is about an hole cast by lamp popping, showing an internal rim of a skiffos. For the identification of the manufacturing technique itself, I use the X-ray analysis. By studying the orientation of the pores, it's possible to detect manufacturing technique. Oblique inclusions and pores indicate wheel throwing. Horizontal ones at the joint indicate coiling technique, and if pores are rounded, means that the vessel is probably made by pinching. Now we'll discuss the results of the technological analysis performed on the select vessels. I will start with the production of a typical UBM vessel, since it's a good example of the first stage of pottery specialization. The rim-to-body fragment of the cup has one vertical handle attached to the rim and to the belly. This kind of handle lying at the same height of the rim. The decoration is composed of vertical lines painted with the multiple brush, which is a typical tool used for decoration of UBM motif. The decoration is quite simple. Vertical lines starting from the lip go over the base of the cup, sometimes coming across each other. This type of decoration is painted also in the handle. All the decoration in this kind of cups has been made with only a single instrument, and we can suppose that it was decorated without the help of the potter's wheel. Through the macroscopic analysis, it was possible to detect on the external surface a fingerprint left by the potter that you can see in the first image, probably while she was decorating the inside of the vessel, which is covered with black dull paint. The radiographic analysis reveals some horizontal voids, fissures in the lower part, and incisions that are at the bottom of part of the vessel. These results indicate that there were imperfections, and sometimes probably related with the primary forming technique. Similar macroscopic characteristics have been identified in other similar cups. In the first image, is a small fingerprint was detected on the internal surface, and a similar incision placed on the lower part of the cup was identified, showing that this kind of vessel were made by potters that were at the same stage of specialization. The large bowl decorated in Nubian style, well made and decorated in glossy glaze, is a very unique piece due to the combination of local shapes in Francavilla with borrowed technique. The native bowl is itself based on sorry Italian shape, and it seems not to have been produced in Greece. We need stative shape and produced with a Greek technique, these bowls with concentric circles and wavy bands is a typical hybrid product. It was produced already from the beginning of the 8th century BC. Here we have another example. In the first image to the left, the rim to shoulder fragment of a skiffos decorated with two horizontal wavy lines. This kind of skiffos was produced in Francavilla Marittima. The paint is black matte, very similar for what it was used to depict the local matte painted vases. Further influenced by the local Enotria pottery production is the upright, slightly incurving lip and carries a thin pink slip, which is similar to that on native Enotrian pottery. The radiographic analysis reveals spiraling and continuous distribution of inclusions and obliquely oriented pores and inclusions. I'm now presenting the different stages of specialization of pottery production according to the studies of the evolution of specialist production. I summarize the main characteristics of each kind of specialization here in this image. Concerning this, concerning this topic, Rue and Corbetta, ethnographic and experimental work has demonstrated that progress in learning wheel throwing is expressed by an increase in pot size and the potter becomes more and more competent. According to these scholars, the first specialization includes vessels up to 3 cm, with potters using only simple thumb index finger pressure because they do not yet know how to center a lump of clay on the wheel. A good example of the first stage of pottery specialization in Eretria is well represented by the cups production. This kind of cups predominates scientifically in the late geometric, and it was produced for more than 1 century without significant changes. As cups are easy to make and were used in one of drinking heavens, they did not require advanced skills, and any failures in the production were inconsequential. Therefore, they made ideal learning objects for beginners. All cups, for example, show errors in clay preparation. Another important thing concerned the fact that the cups were not exported or reproduced in Francavilla Marittima. The production of the skiffoi requires a second stage specialization by the potters. The skiffos, as you can see in the first image, was part of the grave goods in one of the graves of Macchiabate Necropoli in Francavilla Marittima. Unfortunately, the decoration is not present anymore. Probably the external surface was originally covered with a light slip before painting the decoration. The clay is well depurated, only few mica inclusions have been detected by microscopic analysis. The second skiffos from Eretria is chronologically older than the one from Francavilla. The whole surface on the skiffos is covered with a red glossy paint, except the rim and the handle area. The paint has been applied with a brush without taking much care. The clay is also well depurated. For producing this kind of vessel, the potters must be competent centering on the clay. While progression from beginner to expert potter is primarily indicated by vessel A, there is a far-reaching diversity among the most experienced potters reflected in the repertoire of shapes they could produce. A good example of this third stage of specialization is the crater. The crater here, in the first images, we have a crater found in a tomb of Francavilla Marittima. It was manufactured in 2 or more parts. The traces on the attachment of the different parts are still visible in the inside surface of the vessels. What is very important is these plastic knobs that are made on the external rib of both the vessels, both in Francavilla and in Eretria. This is a characteristic applique decoration found on Umbrian crater of this period, and it can put together the two vases. For what concerns the application of the decoration, it has been observed two different levels of execution. This image compares the decorative motifs of two different vessels. The first is a rim to body fragment of a Scyphus from Francavilla, and the second one is a rim fragment of a Cantharos from Eretria. The one from Francavilla has a single cross-edge losanga with interspaced dots and encircled by dots. A brown bed is covering the upper part. On the band, a light brown horizontal wavy line has been applied. For the decoration of the Cantharos, light paint was used, and inside the losanga and the svastika was used as a motif. In the second case that I want to show you, we have the upper wall, in the upper part, the wall fragment of a closed vessel from Francavilla that present the same kind of motif pattern of a fragment of a Cantharos from Eretria. It's possible to make a comparison of the level of execution between the central similar pattern. It is clear the way the potter paints the dots, that before filling the dots with the paint, in the case of Eretria, he has painted a sketch, meaning that the potter wants to be very precise in the decoration. This is not observed in the upper example of the vessel from Francavilla, which has been decorated with the black paint without the outline. In the last part of the presentation, I will focus on the cultic use of this Eubean pottery, Eubean and Otrian pottery, from different contextual contexts in Francavilla Maritime. So what is very important regarding the development of the cult in the sanctuary on the Timpone della Motta and the late 8th century society are the scene painted on apexes. The body of the vessel show a line of boys and girls offering a cup of water to a seated goddess, while on the lid, a girl and a boy dance together. The girl holds an idriska, a smaller version of the vessel that in Greece world always contained water. According to Kleibling, it seems possible to interpret this scene as coming-to-age rituals to prepare adolescents for marriage. Susan Langdon has identified some scenes and others at other sanctuaries, mainly in Greece, and interpreted them along similar lines. Depicts specific rites that reflect the association of young men and girls with a goddess. A more direct interaction with the Greek world is attested in a grave of a high-ranking Enotrian leader found in the burial area de Leo in the necropolis of Machiabate. The grave can be dated to about the third quarter of the 8th century BC. However, in accordance with the Enotrian tradition, a set of vessels was deposited by the feet of the deceased. However, these vessels differ considerably from the grave kit of contemporary burials in the Machiabate for the presence of a well-made crater of the Enotrian Eubean pottery class. Next to the crater, a locally produced kyphos and a small handmade jugglet were placed. Of particular importance, however, is the discovery of a bronze vessel, a cauldron, that was deposited together with the crater. The two vessels serve similar purpose in the Greek world as container of wine mixed with water. Unlike the crater, however, the cauldron had several additional functions and was used to boiling meat and heating water as well. Indeed, several small bones found at the bottom of the cauldron clearly attest to its function in the grave. The arrangement of the Greek goods in grave de Leo differs from Enotrian burial traditions and point to a very far-reaching Hellenization of the men buried in this grave. The last images that I want to show you is an assemblage of materials found in the in the context from the temple 5C, the Santos assemblage include pottery from the in a Ubia style in the upper part, and at the same time the matte painted pottery and impasto pottery. So this kind of vessel we know were used for ritual activities in the same moment, in the last quarter of the 8th century BC. Even in the images, I didn't put the numbers of vessels we found. The majority of the shirts we found in this context, it was from the local impasto pottery. It's possible to draw some conclusion. So far, unique are the potters on workshop producing the so-called Enotrian Ubian pottery on the potter's wheel decorated in glossy glaze. This production contains indigenous form like conical naked bases and large bowls, but also Greek type stands from large craters and the craters themselves, as well as a variety of nice thin-walled drinking cups, like skiffoi. It is evident that this production originated in the wish to make use of sophisticated wine drinking sets. We cannot be sure that were a Ubian potter sitting at the wheel, because hitherto there is no enough evidence of genuine imported Ubian material from the sanctuary or from the tombs. Local potters might have learned to produce this pottery not necessarily at Francavilla Marittima, because other sites which come into view are Ponte Cagnano, Pitecusa, and Canale Janchina, but as yet there is a little evidence of such schooling of local artisans. Thank you for your attention.